Hello, my name is Asia, and I am here to tell my spinal CSF leak story. My leak first began when I was working out super hard, throwing weight above my head, and that evening I felt a small little twinge in my back. That went from a twinge in my back to a couple days later having incredibly sore shoulders, which I initially attributed to just a hard workout. From there, it went to neck pain to out of this world head pain, where it felt like my brain was being pulled down my spine. And so I knew that that wasn't a regular headache. I was unable to work during this process because the only type of relief I got was when I laid down. Anytime I stood up, I couldn't think straight. The pain was crippling. And so I was bedridden for a good amount of time before getting treated. I was able to seek out a community on social media that kind of led me to the neurologist who ended up diagnosing me. It was definitely an experience, to say the least, with navigating, trying to advocate for myself, sitting at three different intersections of a lived experience. So being a woman, being a Black woman, and then having an invisible illness while also not being cognitively how I was pre-leak was very hard, very challenging. Luckily for me, I was able to get a diagnosis relatively quickly. So my leak did show up on imaging for the specialist to be able to identify. Prior to getting to the specialist, all of the other doctors never saw a leak. So I am sealed. I was treated and sealed by a fibrin glue blood patch, and I've been upright ever since. The most frustrating thing living with a spinal CSF leak was the fact that I didn't have a clear timeline of when I would get better. What helped me cope was, aside from my family being there for me, I really believe that just this internal belief that I was going to be okay eventually. So I'm feeling pretty good now. I would say that in reference to my pre-leaking self, I would be maybe at like an 85%. If that's my new normal, then I can take it because I can still live a pretty fulfilling life. I really wish that doctors knew that with spinal CSF leaks, positional headaches are a pretty quick telltale sign. So my advice for sure is to always listen to that intuition and that voice inside of you telling you when something is wrong and when you need to just keep pushing. And that regardless of what the doctors say or what people around you may say, you know your own body. And I just really think the biggest takeaway is just to always extend grace, because you just never really know what anyone is going through.